I don't have a coma problem. I have a continuity problem. We are all actually have been in an intense coma as a defensive measure, sort of like an ostrich sticking his head in the ground to shrink down the fear of annihilation from God because we wanted to be prime creator. We wanted to kick God out of reality. We wanted to get rid of God. And since reality is one, it felt like we were losing all of reality. And then what we did, instead of being honest, we blamed God and said, God's trying to deprive us of reality. And it felt so catastrophic, we tried to shrink the fear down. And so we're identifying with these little bodies saying, oh, I have a little bit of fear, a little bit of death, but not much, not total, not everything. So it's like we're in this intense coma. Coma of forgetfulness. The way out of this coma is to say, I don't have a coma problem, I have a continuity problem. Because if it weren't for the continuity issue, we would drop the entire coma instantly. We'd realize it's ridiculous. We'd realize our mistake is very simple. It's that we've gotten used to the coma and all the little bodies and things we identify with in this coma, like our dreaming in this coma, and we're afraid to let them all go. So that's called the continuity problem. And God has the resolution of the continuity problem. So I don't have a coma problem, I have a continuity problem. Speaking of comas, this is very significant. Michael Schumacher, the great Formula One champion, is still in an induced coma, and they say he may never come out of it. He may be in a permanent vegetative state. All over a completely freakish accident, skiing accident. He was just going normal speed, and it's just the most freakish thing. Now, this symbolizes something very intense. He was the very icon of what I say, the third dimensional Earth. This fearless, risk-taking, death-defying, super fit, athletic, adrenaline junkie, you know, daredevil, who, and rich, super rich and successful, and all this stuff. He was like the hero. And the hero gets tripped up by a hidden treacherous stone, okay? And goes into this terrible accident and is in a coma and may never come out of it. This is what's happening to the third dimensional Earth, actually. This is what's going to happen. We're going to hit an unexpected obstacle, something very hidden and treacherous that most people did not see. You know, the third dimensionals don't see what's coming. I've tried to alert them to this. Why? Because there's a way to escape it, which is ascension to the fifth dimension. The fourth dimensionals are coming into this planet and taking it over. They plan on, well, what's going to happen is the third dimensional paradigm is going to come to an end. It's going to go into this coma, and it's going to be like a vegetative state, and it's finished. If you don't like the fourth dimension, and who does really, you have to ascend to the fifth dimension. So that's what I've been here for, come here for, to try and help third dimensionals ascend to the fifth dimension, and some fourth dimensionals. Actually, there are a lot of fourth dimensionals who are warning us, have been warning us about the fourth dimension, saying, hey, this is a big problem. We need to, you know, ascend. There is a way to ascend. Absolutely is a way to ascend. And what I have found is it is this technique. I don't have a coma problem. I have a continuity problem. It is wrapping all the problems that we've been experiencing in this world, in this coma, and into this one actual problem, which is the continuity issue. Because the coma is all imaginary. We're fleeing an imaginary problem. There is no problem. So all this coma, everything we've done to protect ourselves is totally unnecessary. So they're not real problems at all. We've invented death. We invented bodies. We invented vulnerability. We invented impermanence. It's all a dream. It's a dream of impermanence. It's a dream of vulnerability. It's a dream of instability. It is the Son of God Spirit who invented all this as defensive measures. And it's completely unnecessary and completely unreal. It's just a dream. So, if not for this continuity issue, where we fear like a severe displacement, if we drop all this, an abrupt change, too much of an abrupt change, right? See, no problems anywhere. It'd be too abrupt for us. That's the continuity issue. And that is a real issue for us, but only that is a real issue. Only that. There is no other actual issue. And even that continuity is not quote-unquote real issue, but it's a pragmatically, it's a fact. We have this concern, and it's justified. Is it justified in that we are, it is a big difference between nothing but problems and never any problem. Because we realize there's never been any problem. And then that's just like, it's just, we feel like it's too much for us. So we have this intermediate step called the continuity issue being resolved. Continuity problem gets resolved for us. Easy. And we keep all the form, we keep the forms that the problems appeared to us in. All this stuff, all these problems appearing to us in various formats and forms, we get to keep that. We may have some upgrade, but we still get to keep the basic forms. But now we see it's a problem-free, completely smoothed out feeling that we have. So that's ascending into a higher condition, actually. And the ascension can take on various formats, actually. We can do it while we're here in this world. We can ascend into a higher realm, actually. That is also possible. But the way to do it is to take inventory of every single problem that arises for you and catch it and say, I don't have a dot, dot, dot problem. Name the problem. I have a continuity problem. I did it this morning for like an hour, lying in bed, just going over everything that arose in my mind. I was just watching it, and then I catch it. And I say, okay, I don't have that problem. I have a continuity problem. And gradually my mind began to empty out of problems. Less and less and less and less and less and less. I'm telling you, it's a super powerful technique if you just only use it. And also, keep it simple. When you start to imagine, well, who's going to win the golf tournament today? Keep it simple, keep it simple. Don't start thinking about, okay, maybe this what's going to happen, trying to project what's going to happen. Keep it simple. Forget it. I don't have a competition problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a coma problem. I have a continuity problem. Now, literally, if you apply this, you can be raised from the dead, as it were. And you say, I don't have a death problem. I have a continuity problem. You're exchanging whatever problem you have for acceptance of the continuity problem, which is just honesty. You're saying, yeah, I do have a continuity problem. But the other stuff, no. No, I don't. I made it all up. It's just imaginary. It's not a real problem at all. And I could drop it instantly. Just like a dream. I could awaken from my dream instantly. I'm having a nightmare. I can wake up and say, oh, it's gone. It's gone. Literally, that's the case. So, but instead of waking up abruptly, let's say, okay, I do have a continuity problem. Let's have that resolved. This is the great technique, and the dead can be actually raised from the dead. Someone dies, and yet you speak for their spirit, as we say. We don't have a death problem. I don't have a death problem. I have a continuity problem. You don't have a death problem. You have a continuity problem. And if the spirit accepts that, says, oh, that's true, then come back to life. That's literally true, because death of bodies is all imaginary in the mind. The mind is just imagining all of this. It's not real at all. God did not make death. That's a fact. We made death to try and shrink our fear down and say, oh no, this fear is really only a fear of losing this body. It's not a fear of losing reality. You see, it's a defensive technique that we use. So, I don't have a coma problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a blame problem. I have a continuity problem. This is how we leapfrog over the fourth dimension. And the fourth dimension is no fun at all. It's all about calculation. It's thinking that somehow we can get rid of our fear if we can just calculate everything. You know, just monitor and calculate. Somehow that's going to get rid of our fear. No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. It's a very boring place, the fourth dimension, really. It's a very terrible, terrible experience, the fourth dimension. It's not what we really want at all. So we leapfrog over the fourth dimension by saying, I don't have a fourth dimensional problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a reptilian problem. I have a continuity problem. Leapfrogs right over the reptilians. Had a dream last night, and it was incredible. Oh. They tried to intimidate and scare me, in the reptilians, and it was, I'm not going to even say what I was shown, but the way to leapfrog over it is simply say, I don't have a reptilian problem. I never have had a reptilian problem. I have a continuity problem, you see? So you're not denying that you have any problems. See, that's too much, and that gets you, weakens you, and you're in trouble then. You say, yes, I have a problem, but it's a continuity problem, and that's it. I don't have any problem. I don't have any reptilian problem. I have a continuity problem. And that just like completely pulls the rug out from under the entire situation as far as them being able to hook you. I do not have a reptilian problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an ET problem at all. I have a continuity problem. I have no ET problem. I have a continuity problem. I have no fourth dimensional problem. I have a continuity problem. This is super powerful, totally effective. Now, in the previous, one of the previous videos, I talked about how we're afraid that we might become too obvious if we use this technique. We're going to turn into the shining golden avatar or something. And I said, don't worry, God understands the spirit that we have. It's not going to allow that. If we give everything, all our dreams to God, we're afraid that will just be the shining light. Well, that's not the case. We will appear to be somewhat normal to everybody. Maybe we will appear to be very smoothed out and calm and blissful. But in order, for the sake of mingling among the world, we will maintain various attributes that enable that. So I had faith in that last night, and I said let me give up all everything. All appearances that I have to God. Let me give up. What happens, I started to lay down and go to sleep, and suddenly this all this bright, beautiful visual imagery began of all these strings of beads, like malas, like you wear a necklace of beads. And it was just this incredible treasure chest of unbelievable amount of designs and beautiful beads and super beautiful. And it just went on and on and on and on. I was just watching it. And then I decided, you know what, maybe I've got some hidden treasure that I've been holding back because I don't want to look this way. And I'm afraid that I'm afraid of this. So I said, let me give this up because I trust God will not give me too much notoriety in this world. Because really, notoriety is not a fun thing in this world. And so suddenly, it's like a treasure chest open, and all the beads, the necklaces, beads, now suddenly took on this beauty and luster of this sort of white pearlish sort of thing. The most beautiful jewel you've ever seen in your life, more beautiful than anything I've ever seen. It was incredible. Just this massive treasure chest of gorgeous, gorgeous beads, lustrous beads, and shining beads. It was just amazing. I just said, wow, yeah, that's very lustrous. So. I gave that all up to God because ultimately we are beyond all form, including the most beautiful necklaces possible. That's all a way of us trying to hide from God. So I gave that all up, and so it shows you that there is this principle that we're afraid to be too lustrous in this world, and so we're hiding our luster, as it were, trying to hide it. And what I did was I opened it up. I said, here you go, God, it's all yours, and do whatever you want to with it. It's up to you. So there's this hidden luster that we have within us that we keep locked away just so that we appear to be normal. Now, the upshot of this is that it may be that in doing this, this opens up so that we can see everything else as beautifully lustrous. And yet we remain, to other people, we appear normal to them. Okay, but we're not, our vision is not limited That's what I think is going to happen. That's what I see is happening. For instance, an aunt of my ma saw, she said she didn't see physical bodies at all. People asked her, what do you see when you look at us? What do you see? She says, I see this beautiful, lustrous, like egg-shaped, like pearl-shaped play of lustrous light. That's what I see. When I look at you, that's what I'm seeing. I don't even see your body. And this has also been reported by others. And that is what somehow, that's what came out in my visual imagery, is it's just this gorgeous, lustrous, beautiful fields of lustrous light. And so we can see that. Instead of seeing bodies, we can see them as this beautiful, lustrous pearl. Everyone is this lustrous pearl. And yet we, to other people's sight, we appear to be normal body. So that's how I think it's going to work. So these techniques are working. These techniques are working. This is sharing that has real traction to it. That's what I'm finding out. You want traction at this time. You don't want to be spinning your wheels at this time. You want the tread on the tires to be digging into the asphalt and getting traction and moving, really moving right now. Because just like Schumacher on that beautiful vacation day, skiing in a lovely day, and the slopes were all nice and groomed, and some hidden rock flipped them upside down and came down on some other rock, completely freakish, crazy thing. We think that everything's fine in this world, and we're just going along, and before you know it, this the worst possible scenario is suddenly going to arise. And at that time, we definitely want to have traction. We definitely want to be using these techniques and familiar with these techniques. Be familiar with them ahead of time. Don't wait until the news blows up and you're transfixed by the news, you know. Already have this technique in hand and be skillful at it so that you can meditate, and anything that goes into your field of awareness, just identify it. Give a label to the problem. I don't have a, and then say, I don't have a, you know, this problem. I have a continuity problem. And assert it clearly. And if it's kind of wishy-washy, that's okay. Keep doing it, and you'll become more assertive at it. That way, you won't be transfixed by the news. You won't be hypnotized by it. Say, I don't have a news problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a news problem. I don't have a panic problem. I have a continuity problem. So you just adamantly deny that you can, since you don't have this problem, you can't suffer from it, right? If you don't have a panic problem, you can't suffer from a panic problem. But you do have a continuity problem, so you can experience that, but the continuity problem has been resolved. There's a perfect resolution to it that goes with it from God, the grace of God. So when you accept the continuity problem, the answer is there for you. The resolution is there for you. Whereas a panic problem, it's not, there isn't any resolution there for you. Because God cannot legitimize our fears, because that would then really trap us in our fears. So God has to overlook all our fears, totally unconcerned about any of it, except the continuity problem. And that's the one fear that God does address and says, yes, because you have been dreaming of hiding from imaginary fear for so long, you're afraid to let go of that. That's legitimate in terms of needing help. The other stuff, totally illegitimate. Totally illegitimate. That's why God doesn't seem to, you know, help us out the way we want to be helped. But we are helped by getting the right advice, which is to turn, to deny all problems, all concerns of this world, one by one by one, just keep at it, and get better and better and better, and then it spreads out and generalizes. But deny it all, turn it all over to just this one issue, okay? It's like take all the sins away of the world, concerns, just for just one. You know, sell all your jewelry for the pearl of great price. That is the right advice, actually. Of salvation, of ascension, of freeing us from the dream, of waking us from this dream of fear. This is how it works. But we have to be practiced before things get really out of control. Otherwise, we'll be overwhelmed by it. So, I'm trying to decide what to do. I've not been able to broadcast live or anything like that because I have to upgrade my system. I don't have enough memory to upgrade my system. I'm blocked in every way to do anything. Ustream doesn't work. The audio is no good. I can't fix it. I've tried everything. So, for now, I'm doing this. So it's not live, but it's still being presented in a timely fashion. So I'm thinking about maybe doing some sessions to help people. I don't have a such and such problem. I have a continuity problem. Actually doing a session focused exclusively on that. Maybe I'll edit it to the end of this video. We'll see. Whatever happens is for the best. I don't really know what I'm going to do, but I don't have a decision problem. I have a continuity problem. See, identifying, worried about making a decision. I don't have a decision problem. I have a continuity problem. That's a powerful one. Haven't thought of that before. I don't have a decision problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a crisis problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a dimensional problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an ET problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an elite problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an Illuminati problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a global elite problem. I have a continuity problem. It just leapfrogs over the whole thing. I don't have a reptilian problem. I have a continuity problem. So you're denying that any of this can make any problems for you whatsoever. But you're not throwing all problems away totally, because that would fear too much of an abrupt change. You are keeping just one problem. You are keeping one problem. That's the continuity problem. And rest assured that God has solved that continuity problem for us. I am certain of that. So again, how you leapfrog over all this terrible nightmare, and it is a terrible nightmare. There's no question about it. I don't disagree with it. Those who say, you know, how awful it is. Absolutely, in fact, it's worse than anyone can ever say, our nightmare. It really is. But we can leapfrog over it entirely, okay? I don't have a warfare problem. I have a continuity problem. Now, how do the great teachers who come into the world, how do they help? The grace of God comes into many forms throughout history. The form is one of unconcern about all problems of the world. Unconcern. That's the format. And this unconcern radiates throughout the whole planet. And those who are sensitive pick it up and they say, hey, wait a minute, I think there's a way out. You know, I don't need to be so concerned about all this. But it really boils down to having to practice this. And the great grace of God comes into the world during times of crisis so that we don't quit our spiritual practice, that we don't get caught up in it. We say, oh, no, wait a minute, I don't have a warfare problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a devastation problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a famine problem. I have a continuity problem. And the fact is that all these problems we think we have are actually imaginary. We're imagining them, so we have the power to deny them. But we're too scared to deny all problems, okay? So if we put all these other problems on just one problem, the continuity problem, this is the remedy. So we still have this problem, and yet the resolution to this problem is wonderful, a dream of remembrance. We do have the power to deny them. So in denying that we have these problems, how can we be affected by them anymore? Can't really be affected by them. That's why I say burning up your karma, as it were. Burning them up like a bonfire. So the grace of God comes into the world in various forms, and we recognize that there's like a complete lack of concern for any of our deaths, suffering, sicknesses, misery, problems. No concern at all. And we say, wow, what's going on here? Well, know that these are all imaginary problems that we're imagining for ourselves, and we don't need to, because there is a solution to the continuity problem. Enfold all your problems. Exchange them, really. Exchange all your problems, all your quote-unquote sins. Exchange all of those for just one sin, one problem, the continuity problem, which is not really a sin. It's just the result, a consequence of sin. Having imagined all these problems for so long. I mean, what is sin except imagining problems? Because there are no problems in reality. What is rebellion against God except imagining that there are problems? There's no problems in reality. So sinning, missing the mark, means to imagine problems, that we have problems. And yet, we've done it for so long, to such an incredible extent. It's like the deepest coma, just unbelievably deep coma. We're so used to it, we're afraid to suddenly awake from the coma, you know? Right? It's reasonable to have trepidation about that. And God does recognize that. He says, yeah. Okay. So, deny all your problems except that one problem. That is the secret. That is the secret to returning to the kingdom, to awakening from the coma, to going back home, to realization, is the key. It's the intermediate step that we have to take from a pragmatic standpoint. So what I've been doing is practicing every day and seeing, you know, how's it going. My blood pressure is fine today. This is 2 days, it was a little low. Today it's back to normal. So I don't know if that was a result of the practice I was doing, or the fear of what's coming. Last night I released a lot of tremendous stress somehow, and today I feel fine. So no worries. You know, I have no worries about using this technique. You might notice some pressures, a little bit of something here and there. Sure. But it's not any technique like the mystics used to raise the kundalini, breathing exercise, all this stuff. It's not anything like that. Nothing like that. I've always avoided those things totally. I haven't tried to do any of that stuff. This, to me, is totally safe way. It's the right way to use your mind. Deny all problems except one. But do it individually, like the problems. Just keep noticing what arises in your mind. Don't just say, well, I have no problems, I only have the continuity problem. That's okay to start with, but you need to be more specific too. Be both general and specific. I don't have an existential problem. That's a general thing. I have a continuity problem. See that? But you can say that the generals, that's fine. Whatever arises in your mind. But don't exclude something specific. If you see something specific, go ahead and say it. I don't have a dust problem. I have a continuity problem. See, a lot of us have problems with dust. That's amazing, right? There's dust everywhere. The fact is, everything is dusty in this world, isn't it? It's a dusty world. So I don't have a dust problem. I do not have a dust problem. I have a continuity problem. The fact is, in the death-free paradise realm, which I have seen, there's no dust at all. Nothing's disintegrating at all. Everything is bright and shining and clear. No dust whatsoever. No disintegration of anything is taking place there. So this world here is like actually just constant particles and dust. I mean, using my video camera and sometimes and looking at stuff, you can see just there's dust in the atmosphere, so much dust in the atmosphere all the time, actually. We just don't realize it. The whole world is a world of dust here. But say, I don't have a dust problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a disintegration problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a death problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a dissolution problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a depression problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a despair problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a delusion problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a decadence problem. I have a continuity problem. So, every aspect of this world as it arises, as you go through the day, try to catch everything that arises like that. Whatever you see, just notice like, oh, I don't like that. Name it right away, say. I don't have a lighting problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a weather problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an atmosphere problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a noise problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a nervousness problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a stress problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an apprehension problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a worry problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a political problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a social problem. I have a continuity problem. These are somewhat general. I don't have a fear problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an irritation problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a crime problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a conflict problem. I have a continuity problem. So it's more powerful when you actually spend some time in your own contemplation, watching the mind during the day, catching your own thoughts. These are just some examples that I'm giving. But when you start catching your own thoughts, it's very profound. Because you suddenly have the sense that I can do this. That this actually is going to work for me. And I can actually deny this correctly. And I it's like, wow. It's that kind of feeling. I don't have a sleep problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an energy problem. I have a continuity problem. It's a miracle. It really is a miracle. This technique is miraculous. It's hitting me hard right now. I'm feeling it. I don't have an energy problem. I have a continuity problem. And you say, wow, I can completely get free of all, you know, fatigue and energy problem. I don't have a fatigue problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a decay problem. I have a continuity problem. You could say, I don't have a diet problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a weight problem. I have a continuity problem. If you're thinking about your weight, I don't have a weight problem. I have a continuity problem. It's the right use of denial, because you're both denying and affirming, right? You're denying imaginary problems. You're affirming the one problem, which is pragmatically, we have to deal with, has to be dealt with pragmatically. That's it. Just that one. That's the only one that has to be dealt with. The others don't need to be dealt with in the slightest bit except to deny them. I don't have a coma problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a confusion problem. I have a continuity problem. There, powerful. Wow. I don't have a confusion problem. I have a continuity problem. If you're doing this, you're gonna come across something like this, and you're gonna feel, suddenly you feel the impact, like you threw a big stone in the pond, and it's like, whoo, the waves, it's like, wow, I don't have a confusion problem, I have a continuity problem. What we've been doing up till now is trying to solve each one of these individual problems we have, which are infinite, right? Trying to make them less, to try and solve the continuity problem that way. But that's not how it's done, because actually God solved the continuity problem for us. And we have a perfect resolution already for us. So all we have to do is accept that we have a continuity problem. Not to try and solve all these other problems at all. Just deny them. To say, no, I don't need any of those. I don't need to work on them at all. God has provided a solution to the continuity problem for us, for sure. We get to keep perception. We just have healed perception. We keep perception, and then we have healed perception, and after we experience that long enough, then we can drop perception. That's how it works. So we don't have to work on any of these other problems. That's why we can drop them. Totally unnecessary. That's the great good news, isn't it? That's the truth. That's the gospel. We don't have to work on any of these problems that we have. Trade them all in for just a continuity problem. If we don't have one, we think, oh my gosh, how can I get better at this? I don't have any confusion problem anymore. How do I lessen confusion? We don't need to. All we need to do is solve the continuity problem. It's like having a nightmare. You know, in the nightmare, we're thinking, how do I get rid of all these people who are chasing me? How do I make friends with all of them? And how do I, you know, be comfortable in my dream? And how do I avoid this tsunami and all this, you know, all these terrible stuff in the dream? Someone will say, look, you don't have to. All you have to do is wake up from the dream. You don't have to work on all these imaginary problems in the dream. Just wake up from the dream. But first, we have a happy dream. Smoothed out. Everything's equally smoothed out. So there's no... It's not like any particular problem is solved. Everything is equally smoothed out. Nothing is obstructing the smoothed outness. Nothing is obstructing the smoothed outness. You feel entirely smooth. Smoothness that has no ripples in it whatsoever. Nothing that happens causes the slightest ripple in it. Totally smoothed out. And yet, you're still seeing in the world, still seeing everything. It just doesn't have the slightest effect on this smoothed out feeling. That's the solution of the continuity problem. Not working on anything. You're just abiding in the smoothness, the smoothed outness. And I know some of you are saying, yeah, I can see that. It's simple. So how come we didn't get this before? Fear of the continuity issue has had us madly pursuing remedies for all these problems. Constantly figuring out, how can I get out of this depression? How do I lessen this confusion? How do I, you know, fatigue? How do I, the problems of the world? How do I bring peace to the world? How can I, you know, all, we've been caught up in this trying to help the world. And not realizing what the help really is. I'm feeling something, like, very strong. and, and we fear again. We're afraid, oh, I need to work on my problems, so I need to have my problems to work on them. No, that's all a defense, actually, against awakening. It's a delaying tactic. It's a delaying tactic. Ramana Maharshi said, if you want to not suffer from all the thorns and pebbles in the world, put on a pair of shoes or sandals. Put on a pair of sandals. Instead of trying to pick up every pebble and thorn in the world and, you know, get them off your path as you walk, you say, oh, there's another pebble. Oh, there's another little pebble. I see another one. Oh, that might hurt my feet. Trying to brush, you know, as you walk along your path. Just put on a pair of sandals. Because that's what he's pointing to. This continuity. Accept the continuity problem as your only problem. And everything else is smoothed out for you. It's as if there are no problems for you, except the continuity issue, which is just to abide in the smoothed outness. So you're not working on solving all these problems. That's, again, a delaying tactic of the world. Working on imaginary problems is a delaying tactic of the world. Of course, we believe they're real. Believe, because we want them, we value them. We believe that's protecting us from annihilation, to say, oh, hey, God, I'm working on my problems. Don't bother me. I'm working on my problems. I'm getting there. I'm trying. Yeah, I got a lot of problems. It's going to take a long time, God. Don't wake me up yet. I got a lot of problems. I'm not ready yet. That's why. But when you hear how this, what's being said here, I'm sure there's something in you that's saying, ah, yeah. And when you practice, you're like pushing air into the bonfire, as it were, and it burns brighter, burns faster, and all these problems are like burning up, vanishing. You know, as you're watching a fire, all the logs are still there, right? So you think, oh, the logs are still there. But it's only after the fire's over and you start poking the logs, suddenly they just crumble into just ashes, you know, just finest dust and ashes. You say, whoa, it's gone. The logs are gone. But as we do this practice, all our problems still seem to be here. It's not like my problems have vanished. But I get the sense that something is being incinerated, you know. No question about it. But it's just a subtle thing. Other than that, yeah, everything seems to be still here. Again, after a fire, there's a lot of the logs, sometimes they hold their form, don't they? Kind of hold their form, but actually you touch them, poof, in the dust. That's why the great grace-filled teachers, we say, I got so many problems, and they just, like, they don't relate to the problems at all, really. I say, just focus in this direction. Not concerned about all your so-called problems. You need to free yourself from them. How do we do that? Well, there's this practice. Be unconcerned about having to work on problems. There are no problems in reality. How can you get used to reality, to remember it's reality if you're working on problems? That just delays awakening. There aren't any problems in reality, never have been, never will be. So we won't be working on problems in reality, that's for sure. So if we're spending all our time working on problems here, how can we wake up? We need to have the experience of the smoothed outness. Perfect smooth outness, where we're not feeling any problems at all. And people may say, well, that's selfish. You're not helping me with my problems. Oh, yes, we are, because we're helping you with the one problem you really have, which is the continuity problem. That you are being helped with by this, experiencing this smoothed outness, okay? That you are being helped with. So deny all problems except for one and affirm one problem. That is the secret. That is the secret. That is the fast path. That is the path that has traction. It's just been tough getting to this point because of all the other advice in the world, which is really delaying advice. I mean, it's like a slow way. And we don't have time. We don't have time for the slow ways anymore. We really don't. Because the troubles are treacherously going to be upon us. So we have to have the quick, fast, pure, direct, you know, effective traction way, the way that really has traction for us, that we can actually get it done. That's what's necessary. And it's been difficult for me to boil it down to this point, because I want to acknowledge everybody else's, what they've done, etc. But, you know, at this point, we got to get it done. You know, there's no more time for niceties and all this stuff. You know, we got to get it done. I don't have a delay problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a delay problem. I have a continuity problem. Incinerates all delay. If you know that focus, if it were perfect focus, your karma would be incinerated. I don't have a delay problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a delay problem. I have a continuity problem. I feel this is changing like my vibrational state or something, no question. I do not have a delay problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't let anybody divert you from saying, I have a continuity problem. That's the only problem I have. Because they'll try to say, push you into every other problem except acknowledging the one problem, the continuity problem. So you have to be fiercely say, no, I do have a continuity problem. That's the only problem I have. I don't have a delay problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a devastation problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a devastation problem. I have a continuity problem. This is the technique. Because you're not going overboard. You're still saying, yes, I do have a problem. You're agreeing, I do have a problem. It's the continuity problem. I don't have any other problem. The ego, it cannot deal with this. It's the end for the ego. This technique is the end for the ego. The ego tries to get you into saying, I don't have any problems, which then frightens you because of the continuity issue. And then you go back to working on problems, like, oh, I better work on these problems. So it tries to get you to jump, catapult yourself back in reality, knowing you won't do so, knowing it'll cause you fear. So by this technique, you completely undermine the ego. Say, oh yes, ego, I definitely have a problem. I have a huge problem. I have the continuity problem. Absolutely. I own it entirely. I do have that problem. I won't let you take it away from me. I do have that problem. I don't have any other problem, though. It's the only problem I have. And I'm denying all other problems. It's the end of the ego. There's nothing the ego can say, really, to this. Can't really interfere. I've not really experienced much interference from the ego in using this. It's just, what can it say? You know? And ultimately, there is no entity ego, actually. It's just the sum total of all our defenses, which are drilled through by this technique. It actually gets us past all of that. I don't have a defensive problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a defensive problem. I have a continuity problem. The key is to actually practice it, not just intellectually conceptualize it and say, okay, it sounds like conceptually it's pretty good, and then that's it. That's not going to work. Say, I don't have a conceptual problem. I have a continuity problem. Again, identify the tricks that the ego is using and label it, name it, you know? I don't have a conceptualizing problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an intellectualizing problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a complexity problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a complexity problem. I have a continuity problem. If you do this right, you'll feel some kind of really impactful, very impactful, as I'm feeling, very impactful. I don't have a delay problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have any delay problem. I don't have a delay problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a distraction problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a noise problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a distraction problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an attention problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an awareness problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a distraction problem, I have a continuity problem. And it's up to us, because since these are all problems we've imagined for ourselves, it's up to us to deny them. And say, no, I don't have that problem. But I do have the continuity problem. You don't want to deny the continuity problem, because that'll throw you into too much fear. Then you'd say, how do I get back to experiencing zero problems ever, you know? Zero dimensionality, no. In terms of problems, zero dimensionality. In terms of obstructions, zero dimensionality. So we don't want to deny we have a continuity problem. We want to affirm it. We want to affirm it. It's the one problem that we affirm. You know, it's the whole model of psychotherapy is off track. It's a delaying game, actually. Because they tell you, you got to just to bring up your problems. Oh yeah, I have this problem. I got you know, problems with. I felt insecure growing up. I feel my body image isn't what I want to be. You know, I need more self-confidence. On and on and on and on. You wallow in this swamp. That's not the way. That's affirming the wrong thing. Deny that you have any problems except the continuity problem. Affirm that you have a continuity problem. Say, I don't have a self-confidence problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a body image problem. I have a continuity problem. So instead of affirming all these other problems, which are imaginary, affirm the one problem which is pragmatically does have to be resolved. Imagine the imaginary problems don't have to be resolved, but the continuity issue does need to be resolved because it's a result of abiding in imaginary problems for so long. So we're so used to the wrong model that doesn't work. We're so used to self-examination, and I've wasted my whole life at that, you know. It's a total waste of time. It doesn't work. Oh yeah, look at my problems. Poor me, you know, I got this and this problem, this problem, this problem. Why do I don't feel so good, you know? You spend your entire life doing that. Waste of time. Literally a waste of time. Instead, deny all problems except the one. I don't even have a birth problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a physical problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a body problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a vulnerability problem. I have a continuity problem. You are so enculturated in the wrong way, it doesn't work. It is super difficult to free oneself from that paradigm that we're in. Super difficult. I know, because I've been through it. It's incredibly difficult. We just assume, you know, that, oh yeah, of course I'm working on my problems. That's what we're supposed to do. That will work. I've never seen it really work for anybody. Not really. No. These are all imaginary problems that we imagine for ourselves to keep ourselves from what we think is a greater problem. So we may be working on it, but at the same time, we're also making sure that we have plenty of problems. If we may solve one, we give ourselves two more, you know. That's what happens. That's what happens. That's why therapists are always scratching their heads, like saying, what? You know, they make up all these names for this resistance of their clients, you know. Of course, that's what happens. They don't understand that what's really going on. So the way is to, you might say, I don't have a psychiatric problem. I have a continuity problem. Now, you don't stop your treatment for whatever it is until, because you still have some belief in it. But when the perfect smoothed outness is experienced, you don't have any more issues whatsoever. You're only experiencing this problem-free smoothed outness. That's the end to all psychiatric problems. It's the end to all problems, period. But in the meantime, continue to work on this technique, but still keep your crutches. You know, don't throw your crutches away. Let the crutches be smoothed out. Let the whole thing be smoothed out first. If you have high blood pressure, you say, I don't have a high blood pressure problem. I have a continuity problem. Right? Don't let the ego trick you into saying, oh, okay, I'm going to show faith and get rid of my medicine. And then, of course, you'll panic later on. And then people get so angry at you and say, ooh, what an idiot. Who's telling you to do this idiocy? You know, that's all a trick of the ego to keep your delay going. Now, of course, you still take your medicine, keep your blood pressure smoothed out, etc. But keep the bonfire going of this right affirmation, right denial, right affirmation technique. Just keep it going. And eventually, you'll reach the point where this, the perfect smoothed outness is there. And then you'll know what to do in terms of somebody feel happy. Maybe you will. Maybe you will keep taking a little bit of medicine to make everybody happy, you know, so they don't get too nervous. Some of the great teachers like Ramana Maharshi and Sri Nisargadatta, I think they both had throat cancer or something, and yet they said, look, it's not touching my smoothed outness at all. So it's not being untouched by this totally, but you need to see that, make you feel like I'm just a normal person here living, you know, with you, and no awe or anything like that. So if the body wants to have this throat cancer and die, that's fine with me. It doesn't touch me at all. Not in the slightest bit. So don't get stuck on any one thing that you're any problem you're denying. Don't get stuck on it. Don't let it. I don't have a stuck problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a fixation problem. I have a continuity problem. See, we're getting fixated on, oh, my high blood pressure, what if I deny this, etc. Say, no. I don't have a fixation problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an obsession problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have any obsession problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have any medical problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have any doctor problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have any medicine problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't let anything turn into a problem. Identify it and say, no, I'm trading that in for a continuity problem. I don't have any treatment problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have any cancer problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't be afraid of any problem. Don't let any problem scare you. They're all imaginary. Cancer, name it. I don't have a cancer problem. I have a continuity problem. And then say, I don't have a fixation problem. I have a continuity problem. And just move on to the next. Don't get hung up on anyone like, wow, I just said I didn't have a cancer problem. Yeah. I don't have a surprise problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an amazement problem. I have a continuity problem. Because we're going for that perfect smooth outness. Perfect smooth outness. So I don't have an amazement problem. I don't have a shock problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a flu problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an emphysema problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a pneumonia problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a heart problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a health problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a death problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an age problem. I have a continuity problem. So again, we're not going for like, well, I don't have an age problem. We're going for, I have a continuity problem. See, the remedy of which is with it, the perfect smoothness. That's what we're going for. So we're not trying to say, hey, look, everybody, I'm healthy. I don't have a health problem. No, we're going for, I have a continuity problem. And the remedy is part of that, is with it. Grace of God has a remedy. I'm feeling totally smoothed out. I'm feeling this total smoothed outness. Total smoothed outness is what I'm feeling. It's not anything to do with health or anything else. It's just a totally smoothed out feeling, no problems. Feeling of just no problem, smooth outness, seamless smooth outness. So if you were just to deny, I don't have any health problems, that the ego would still have us. So we say, I don't have a health problem, I have a continuity problem. You see, you're transferring over to the continuity problem. Don't just get into just denial. That's big trouble. You can run into big trouble that way. I don't have a loneliness problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a pain problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a pain problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a paralysis problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a functionality problem. I have a continuity problem. Just be very intrepid. Make sure you, whatever it is, you catch it. Don't let anything escape your notice. Don't let anything intimidate you. Any of these problems intimidate you. I don't have a comprehension problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't I don't have a stupidity problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a confusion problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have any confusion problem. I have a continuity problem. See, now we've never used our minds this way, have we? We have never used our minds this way. Amazing. And yet how simple it is to use our mind this way. I don't have a trapped problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an imprisonment problem. I have a continuity problem. If you're in prison or jail or something, say, I don't have a prison problem. I have a continuity problem. Just assert that. I don't have a prison problem. I have a continuity problem. Very, very simple. Very, very simple. If you live in an area, let's say crime, I don't have a crime problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a crime problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a crisis problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a danger problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a vulnerability problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a bully problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a bullying problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an intimidation problem. I have a continuity problem. And don't stick with just, you know, one little area like that's most interesting to you. Make sure you dig deep, because actually all the problems of the world, everybody has all those problems actually. And make sure we're not holding one back, saying, no, I better hold on to this problem. See, I don't have a glamour problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a beauty problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a clothes problem. I have a continuity problem. You can say, I don't have a Barbie doll problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a trophy wife problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an appearance problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a pretension problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an image problem. I have a continuity problem. Just burn up whatever, all the complexes. I don't have a sensuality problem. I have a continuity problem. That's a strong one for many people. I don't have a sensuality problem. I have a continuity problem. Incinerate the whole thing. I don't have a sensitivity problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a sensitivity problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a selfishness problem. I have a continuity problem. It goes on and on and on, right? So you have to practice it with your own issues that arise. Whatever arises for you, catch it. And when your mind starts making a movie, you know, stop it. Say, keep it simple. Keep it simple. I'm busy here. Keep it simple. I don't have a movie problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a TV problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a trivia problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a game show problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a game show problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a sports problem. I have a continuity problem. A competition problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an ego problem. I have a continuity problem. There you go. I don't have an ego problem. I have a continuity problem. This is real therapy. So don't chicken out of this therapy. You'd be glad that you didn't, because, again, look at Schumacher, you know, that look what can happen. Pride goeth before a fall, unexpectedly. The world is full of itself, and it thinks it has all the answers. It thinks it has the right therapy for everything. No, it doesn't. It doesn't. The therapy of the world doesn't work. It doesn't work. I know. I've checked it all out. It doesn't work. So don't have pride in the world. I don't have a pride problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a therapy problem. I have a continuity problem. Say that. I don't have a therapy problem. I have a continuity problem. All right. This is a lot for now. Very good. Very great. Just check in with yourself, how you feel. And you say, I don't have a feeling problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a check-in problem. I have a continuity problem. And just keep it going. It's the steamroller. It's laying out the path. It steamrolls the path, smooths out the path. It's the great steamroller technique. Smooths it out, going towards total feeling of total smoothedness. That's it. All right, that is it.